What's going on, good people? Once again, it's your chill brother from another, Mr. All About My Biz, Kyle Turner, back in the studio once again. And if you hear me, y'all know what time it is, man. Y'all know what time it is. Get a little hype, get a little crazy. It's time for yet another episode of the Playbook Podcast. It's a special day, y'all. It's the second Juneteenth for some. For some, it's happy 4th of July. But listen, either way, you slice it, it's a day of freedom, and it's a day of independence to each and every one of us, all right? So enough of the bantering in regards to that. Either way, listen, I'm glad you guys have come aboard once again. We're just trying to expand our horizons. Again, when we take the barbershop to your podcast, all right? So listen, as always, y'all, I need you guys to go to Spreaker. I need you guys to go to Spotify, Anchor, Google Podcasts, and wherever you find your podcast platforms to continue to help support the Playbook Podcast. Listen, we're just trying to make this thing global, man. We're just trying to go from each level. We're just trying to level up. We're just trying to level up over here, all right? So your love, your support, your sharing, your commenting, all of that is going to help us continue to exactly expand our horizons. Listen, in this episode, family, the main topic I want to talk about is cracking the case. And y'all know I love acronyms, right? So I'm going to leave that on the cliffhanger for you. And I'm going to give you guys that in the championship speech at the end of the show. All right. So y'all be cracking the case. Cracking the case, you know, the whole detective mystery thing, CSI, all that stuff. But we got to, of course, apply it to our everyday life mentality and how we go about things. We're going to talk about that in the championship speech. So y'all go ahead and be on standby for that. Of course, we got to go around the NBA, around the association. We got everything set up for the finals now. As the Milwaukee Bucks break the curse and advance to the NBA finals for the first time since 1974, they get to the finals for the first time since 1974 when afros and bell bottoms were still fashionable, when Lew Alcindor, before he became Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. That's how long it's been since the Milwaukee Bucks have made it to the NBA Finals. They're on their way to face the Phoenix Suns, who, of course, they're making it for the first time since 1993. So they've been dancing in the streets of Phoenix since Thursday, since it was 1993. So we got the Suns, we got the Bucks. I got the NBA Finals preview and predictions as well. We got the NBA Draft Combine that happened a couple of weeks ago. The NBA Draft is right around the corner as well. So we got to talk about what's going on with the draft, different guys, whose stock is going up and whose stock is going down. We're going to move the chains around the NFL as the Green Bay Packers are looking to secure the bag, the super bag for DeVante Adams to make him the highest paid wide receiver in the NFL. Also, New Orleans Saints, they re-signed Ryan Ramczyk, making him the highest paid right tackle. We're going to talk about that as well. And Trevor Lawrence still remains unsigned for the Jacksonville Jaguars. We're going to get into that as well. That's a little bit shaky if you're a Jacksonville Jaguars fan. Also, of course, we got the trivia question of the day. We got Stop Playing. Stop Playing with the best moments of the playoffs so far. And listen, I got the championship speech as always, y'all. So y'all go ahead, buckle up y'all seatbelts. We're going to have a nice, good old cruise on this Independence Weekend, all right? It's your boy, once again, Mr. All About My Biz. And this is the Playbook Podcast. Let's go. What's really going on, family? It's your chill brother from another. And listen, man, I'm just trying to handle my biz so I can take care of my future kids, family. And on this Independence Weekend, y'all, listen, y'all, I want y'all to feel free. And of course, with everything that's been going on with COVID, the pandemic, everything's starting to open back up. So listen, y'all go ahead, enjoy yourself, go to the beach, enjoy your time, vacation time with your family, your friends, etc. Especially, yo, since life is short. And of course, it's best at, you know, if everyone's on the same page, let's all be able to have that time where, hey, let's go ahead and enjoy ourselves. Let's not be so predicated on the minuscule things. And let's go ahead and enjoy our time that we have here on this earth, right? That's all it's about, right? It should be about that. But either way, I digress. As always, y'all, it's all about expanding our horizons, where we bring the barbershop to your podcast, y'all. So listen, go to Spotify, Anchor, Spreaker, Google Podcasts, also on YouTube as well. Also going to be on iHeartRadio shortly. So listen, the YouTube page is the Playbook Podcast, Kyle Turner. Listen, I need y'all to subscribe to that page. I need you guys to like. I need y'all to share that, John, as well, wherever you are. And again, we're just trying to make this thing global. We're just trying to expand our horizon. We're just trying to go level to level. We're just trying to level up, all right? We just get warmed up, okay? Each and every week, each and every Monday, you know where to find your boy, all right? So listen, without further ado, let's get right into the stuff, all right? No more fluff. Let's get into the stuff, all right? Which is, let's get right into the open the tip. We pat the rock around the association. After a long, excruciating season, we now have our NBA Finals matchup. We got the Milwaukee Bucks in one corner. We got the Phoenix Suns in another corner. And they're about to get it on. I'm sorry, I had to get a little MMA right there. I had to get my whole Bruce Buffer going on real quick, okay? Listen, we got two heavyweight fighters about to fight it off for the ultimate prize in the NBA, as the Milwaukee Bucks and the Phoenix Suns are now squared up to face in the finals. Before that, we had game six in the A. We had Milwaukee, we got Atlanta, we got Trae Young fighting his way through to try to play in game six. Young brother did all he could to try to get his team over the hump. My man was pretty much on 40%. Well, you gotta love the moxie. You gotta love the heart that Trae Young showed throughout this entire playoff series. He's the first player since LeBron to have 28 points and almost 10 assists in his first playoff run. It's just LeBron and Trae Young. Some serious company for a young brother making his first NBA playoffs run. Man, big shout out to Trae Young. Ice Trae, you did your thing, my man. But Milwaukee got the last laugh. Middleton, Holiday was able to get it done as Milwaukee cruised to a game six win. They were up by as much as 22 at one point, and they got it done in the A, on their home court, on the road. No Giannis. Impressive enough. Brooke Lopez came to play. Bobby Portis, Pat Connaughton, and listen, Middleton and Holiday combined for 53 points, and Milwaukee is going to the NBA Finals. Coach Bud getting over the hump. I still have my questions in regards to him, but hey, y'all, go ahead and drink this up, man. Go ahead and enjoy it. Enjoy it, man. It's been a long time coming. But listen, you got a team in Phoenix that's equally as hungry to get it done. And listen, let's get right into the NBA Finals preview, okay? So we got the Phoenix Suns. We got the Milwaukee Bucks. And listen, if you talk about bench, you got to go with Phoenix with the edge in that particular way. You got campaign Cam Johnson off the bench of the Phoenix Suns. You also have Torrey Craig as well. And listen, for him, NBA Finals is a win-win for him. Either way, he's going to get a ring because he spent time with Milwaukee before he was traded to Phoenix. And I mean, bruh, that's what you want in life, right? You know, you can get your ice cream with your sprinkles, or you can get the butter pecan. You can get whatever you want, and still you can win if you're Torrey Craig. So, yo, I mean, if I'm him, I'm like, yo, I don't even care. I win either or, but I'm sorry. I ain't going to lie. I ain't going to front. The competitor in me is going to want to be like, I want to win with the team that actually traded for me and we're in the finals now. That's just me. That's just how I get down. You know what I'm saying? But you got to give the edge to Phoenix with the bench right now. Milwaukee, I mean, you got Pat Connaughton. You got Bobby Portis. You got Brent Forbes as well. But I think the edge goes a little bit towards Phoenix in regards to the bench. I like campaign. Campaign is about to get the bag. He's been campaigning for another bag with his play during these playoffs. And listen, I can't even front Phoenix for actually giving him more because of what he was able to show, especially in game number one without Chris Paul. 29-9 and no turnovers. That's big time for my man, from going to handshakes to actually possibly shaking the hands of James Jones and the Phoenix Suns ownership for a greater bag and a bigger contract this offseason coming up for my man campaign. All right, listen. Also, you got to give to the X factors in this whole finals thing, right? You know, the X factor could be for Milwaukee is Bobby Portis. He's been playing out of his mind. on here recently. Hard-nosed guy, been doing it for a while, can do it on the offensive end, has really been bringing his hard hat more on the defensive end as well. And if you're Phoenix, you got to look at Jameson Crowder, right? I mean, you got to look at Crowder for the Phoenix Suns, not Jameson Crowder. We're not talking NFL. We're talking about Crowder for the Phoenix Suns. And listen, it's all about whether or not he's going to come up big for Phoenix if they're going to get past the Milwaukee Bucks. Because his play in the last couple of games was huge for them. If not for his play knocking down threes, this could have been a game seven possibly in Phoenix. But him being able to knock down the three ball, he's the only person out of any team in the finals where he got finals experience. He's been to the finals six times. He has six finals appearances with no ring yet. He got an opportunity now with Phoenix, and I don't think this brother is going to blow the opportunity for the Phoenix Suns. So those are the X factors in this. You got to see whether or not Giannis is going to play or not for the Milwaukee Bucks. So we got to see where everything goes. Edge has to go to Phoenix and their coaching staff. I like Monty Williams to be able to make good adjustments on the fly and have his team execute the way they need to, right? You seen with Coach Bud and the Bucks throughout this playoffs where they have a hard time making smart decisions on the offensive side of the ball. Jay Crowder is going to be huge for the Phoenix Suns if they're going to try to get the NBA championship to the Phoenix Suns for the first time in franchise history. So his play, along with Chris Paul, him doing his thing, being the point guard of this generation. Here's my prediction, y'all. I got Phoenix in six. I got the Phoenix Suns winning the NBA championship in six games. Yes, this means, to me, this means more to Giannis. A little slightly more than Chris Paul. Chris Paul is already going to be a Hall of Famer. Regardless, Giannis has still got to build his legacy. I mean, you're a two-time MVP already. That's great. Defensive Player of the Year, that's great. But the knock on you is whether or not you can win a championship. And to me, Chris Paul is going to have this Suns team hungry enough to get it done. And I think the Phoenix Suns win the NBA title in six games. What say you? What's your pick? Who you got? I'm going with Phoenix in six. What say you? Listen, leave your comments in the show notes in the bottom of the Anchor app, the Spotify app, also on YouTube as well. Let me know who you got winning the chip this season in the NBA. Got some young players on both squads looking to actually get the brass ring. So we got some more young guys also trying to make it to the league since they got the NBA draft coming in the next couple of weeks as well. NBA draft combine was a couple of weeks ago. We got some guys making the move up in the draft and got some guys taking a dip down in the draft as well. Got some guys moving up. VCU guard Nashawn Bones Highland had a great showing in the scrimmage. A young brother, 17 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists in the first scrimmage in front of all the scouts before they actually, you know, how they get going and talking with each other, et cetera, et cetera. They were really more focused with the first scrimmage. My man came to play in that game as well. He's probably going to find his way moving up in the draft with that play in the scrimmage. Also, Iowa wing Joe Wieskamp. I mean, going into it, there were some question marks in regards to his athleticism, if he was able to actually, you know, get in there, get a little physical in the draft process. But he came to play 26 and 10 in the scrimmage as well. He's going to make his way up. He was seen as a second rounder, possibly. He's probably going to make his way into the mid second round now if you're Joe Wieskamp. Also, some guys making a move down, though. Max Abmas out of Oral Roberts. You remember the young brother from Oral Roberts knocking down money ball after money ball, giving it to folk. My man had a struggle in Chicago with the scrimmage, man. He measured at 5'10 and a half. probably the shortest guy there at the combine. 28 and a half inch off vert.